Here's what you need to know about glioblastoma. Hi, I'm Sheila Singh. I'm a neurosurgeon and a scientist at McMaster University and the director of the new Center for Discovery in Cancer Research. Glioblastoma is the most common primary malignant adult brain tumor. Glioblastoma is very invasive. It's not a tumor that stays in one place. It tends to spread throughout the brain. Glioblastoma is diagnosed by a patient presenting with common neurological symptoms. Some of these symptoms include headache, vomiting, or visual changes. Sometimes there can be a change in a person's personality or character. In the past 5 years, scientists have uncovered new knowledge about glioblastoma that has been very illuminating. We have recently discovered that if you look at glioblastoma as a whole, it's very confusing. It's a heterogeneous tumor. That means that every cell in the tumor is different, and there are many different cells that are difficult to target with only one drug. When we learn through the application of single-cell sequencing technology, glioblastoma can be deconvoluted down to the level of a single cell, we figured out that there are different signals sent by all these different cells, and perhaps these different signals could be targeted not by one drug, but by multiple different treatments. Sometimes looking at treatments for glioblastoma can be discouraging. We've had the same standard of care for over 2 decades. And the reason for this is because we haven't been able to find anything better yet. However, on the horizon, there are new clinical trials investigating brand new therapies. And these are therapies called immunotherapies. These are therapies that harness the patient's own immune system to fight the tumor. There are 2 new types of immunotherapies for glioblastoma that look particularly promising. One is a type of vaccine, and vaccines are good at targeting multiple different targets on a cell surface, which makes it especially promising for glioblastoma. The second new type of therapy is called CAR T-cell therapy. CAR T-cell stands for chimeric antigen receptor T-cell. T-cells are the soldiers of our immune system, and they're known to go into the body and attack infections. What if you could take a T-cell and program it to go after a target on the surface of a glioblastoma cell? What if you could infuse those genetically engineered CAR T-cells back into the patient, and then those cells could go and attack the glioblastoma? These are the kind of advances that are happening right now, and I believe there'll be a lot of hope for patients in the very near future.